Big businesses and brands that suffered during the pandemic found their way back, but the smaller stores still suffer.
This lockdown has been a real tough phase of my life. I have seen bad days, but this was the worst.
Last year, we helped small businesses through Diwali. So this year, we decided to bring it back. Presenting not just a Cadbury ad. This Diwali, we helped hundreds of small businesses by making India's biggest brand ambassador be their brand ambassador.
This Diwali, I pass for international employees, say he, come from Shotgun. On Pedal, buy footwear. Up to now, on the Stanley Chashman, Bagal Valley, Heaven, I'm official Zayn. Siddhi Vinayak Electronics, in smartphone, Karita, from Arkadas, 34-7.
We used machine learning to recreate Shah Rukh Khan's face and voice to take the local store names in the ads.
This Diwali, aap bhi apne paas wale choice of fashion se hi, paas wale Aajkal fashion se hi, Royal fashion se hi, NK cloth se hi, paas wale Lakshmi collection se hi, this Diwali, aap.
Different versions of the same ad with local store names were targeted as per the PIN code of the viewer, showing them only the nearby stores. But it is impossible to cover all the stores. So we gave the power to the people to create their own version of not just a Cadbury ad. Any small business owner could promote their stores through their own social media networks like WhatsApp forwards and other social media pages. Cadbury celebrations, not just a Cadbury ad.
Okay, so. Am I audible clearly?
Yes.
Okay. So, how was the video? Please react with the emojis in the Teams, and I'm waiting. I hope that video inspired you a lot. And this video is the best example of how technology can affect the day-to-day life and how technology can really impact a person's life. Okay. Many people are reacting. Okay. So let's move forward. I hope many of you will create such great solutions to solve those 17 goals. Okay. Let's move forward with our event. Okay. So as I said earlier, let me recall, because many people just joined in 5 minutes. So let me rewind to the first slide. Okay, so guys, please hold on. Let me just summarize what we discussed. So Google Developer Students Club 2022 Solution Challenge. So we are going to discuss this in upcoming remaining part of the event. And basically, this event is an long hackathon where we aim to solve the 17 sustainable development goals using Google technology. And the 17 sustainable goals are made by the United Nations in 2015, and they aim to achieve it by 2030. So what we are going to do in the solution challenge is that we'll be solving these 17 different goals or 17 different problems in the society. So first is no poverty, so second is zero hunger. And I'll just move to the slide, next slides. I won't dictate it. It will make even more longer. Okay. So you can find these 17 different goals in Solution Challenge websites, or you can find them on United Nations Sustainable Development Goals page. Don't worry, we'll provide you with the PPT and all the links. Okay. So here we go. So here is the timeline for the Solution Challenge. So this event will go on till July, okay. But you have to submit the solution before the March 31st. So the first step would be to become a part of a solution challenge event, first step would be joining a Google Developer Student Club. So first of all, you have to go to the community page of your respective GDSE chapter and just press that join now button, and that's it. You'll become the member, and then you will become eligible to be a part of solution challenge. And in case if there is no GDSE chapter at your college, there are many students in this meeting who are not from DY Patil College of Engineering. So you people don't worry. If you don't have GDSE at your college, you just have to enter DY Patil College of Engineering. And the next step would be get an teammate from DY Patil College of Engineering. Okay, if you don't have GDSE chapter, enter the GDSE chapter nearest near to you, and from that college, just get one team member. So next step would be to register for the 2022 Solution Challenge by submitting this form. So here's the link. We'll give you this link on the groups and Discord server as well. And this link will be in the PPT, which will be uploaded to that community page only. So for third step is forming a team. So you are building a solution, right? And you can't build it all by yourself. You'll need a team member. So what Google Solution Challenge events guidelines are that you form a team with a minimum of 2 members and maximum of 4 members. Then next step is selecting and one or more sustainable development goals, which we discussed earlier in previous slides, and then identify a solution for that. Okay, select a goal, identify a solution, and then build that solution. And if you don't know how to build, then learn it, because you have ample amount of time till 31st of March to learn any Google tech and build a solution for that. Okay. So the seventh step would be testing your solution with real users. Okay. And this is most important, because this carries marks. Okay. And step eight would be iterate. So you have to test your solution, then gather honest feedback from the users, and find problems in your solution, and again identify a solution for that problem, then again build that. And this you have to iterate and optimize your solution till 31st of March. On 31st of March, like before 31st of March, you have to record a demo video of your solution and submit it on that form. So you might be thinking, in that video, what should we include? So you have to include, record your screen, or you can just record a video of yourself and your team members explaining about the solution, that what goals you are covering, what technology you are using, and have you tested the your solution with real users. You can also record the implementation part of that solution. And then after submitting, Google's judge panel will judge your solution, and then they'll analyze and mark your solution. And top 50 solutions all over the world will be announced between mid of April. And those 50 teams will be provided with mentorship from Google developers and experts during the month of May. After that, they'll again work on their solutions, and Google will announce the 10 finalists in June. And from that 10 finalists, top 3 solutions will be announced live on the YouTube. And that's it. That marks as the end of the solution challenge. So let's move to the next slide. We'll discuss more about what's the prizes and eligibility. Okay. So first of all, let's discuss what are the prizes. So as soon as you register for the solution challenge, you'll definitely get the digital profile badge and official certificate. Okay. So what is digital profile badge? All of you must be having Google developer profiles. Okay. And there's an option of digital profile badges. So their badge will be added that you participated in solution challenge in 2022, and plus you'll get an official certificate. Even if you you know, don't win the challenge, you'll definitely get these two things. And for the top 50 teams, they'll receive and customized mentorship from Googlers and experts, and they'll receive and branded t-shirt and certificate. Top 10 finalists will receive mentorship, swag box, and opportunity to showcase solutions to Googlers and developers all across the world on Demo Day. We'll discuss more about Demo Day in upcoming slides. And the finalist will get swag box. They'll receive a cash prize of $1,000 per student. And the final top three winners will get $3,000 each as a cash prize from Google. And also they'll get that swag box and certificates also. And they'll, their solution will be featured on Google Developers blog. Okay, so these were the prizes. And let's move forward. Okay, so this is the judging criteria for the solution challenge. Once you submit the solution by 31st of March, the Google's panel will judge your solution based on these criteria. So they'll mark you out of 100. The criteria would be like the impact of that solution will carry 60 points, and the technology which you have used to build that solution will carry 40 points. So these 60 points will be further breakdown into five criteria. That is, does the entry establish a clear challenge focused on one or more of the United Nations 17 SDGs? So are you targeting any sustainable development goal or not, which carries 10 points? Then how effectively your solution addresses to this challenge, which will carry 20 points? Then is there any evidence of next step, which means is there any scope of is there any future scope or something like that, which will carry 10 points? Then is the solution thoroughly tested with real users, which will carry 10 points? As I explicitly mentioned in previous slides, is there any evidence that the solution was iterated upon based on users' feedback? These carry 10 points. So everything which I was mentioned in the timeline, which every part was important, and every part carries marks. Okay, let's move to the technology part, which carries 40 marks, and those 40 marks are further breakdown into 4 points. So does the solution implement all the technical components needed to solve the challenge, which carry 10 marks? Then has the team clearly explained what Google tech they have used in that video? That will carry 10 points. And does the video demonstrate how the solution works? And these many points, which will carry 10 points. And last would be, has the team made an effective product and technical decisions for their solution? It will carry 10 points. I hope this is clear to you. Let's move to the next slide. Okay, so these are the overview videos of solution challenge. You can, if you don't understand something right now, you can always reach out to us, but also you can watch these videos. These videos are directly recorded by the official Googlers. So we'll provide you, I'll not play these videos right now, I'll provide you these videos in that PPT itself. Okay. So here in this meeting, we have first year students, second year students, and third year students as well. So many of you don't know anything about development. You don't know, you know about web development, Android development, but many of the students don't know. They are just beginners in their tech journey. Okay, so no worries. Google has covered that you for that. Google has covered everything for you people. Also, Google gives you the resources to learn new skills and which you can learn and side by side build your project. Okay, so the best way to learn any tech is that you start learning it and start building the project side by side. So this is the best way. You can find the resources for the Kotlin, Flutter, TensorFlow, Google Actions, Firebase, Data Science Cloud, and Web Pathways. We'll provide you with all these links. Solution challenge is for beginners, intermediate developers, and advanced developers. So this is for everyone. And these are the tutorial videos regarding how to identify a solution for any certain problem. Okay, so many a times you'll be facing that you'll be confused about what solution to build regarding certain problem. For example, let's pick an topic. For example, life on land, right? There was this was one of the 17 sustainable development goals. So to identify a solution on that problem, you need to follow a certain approach. That approach is described in these videos. You can go through these videos later. And also this design sprint kit is there, always there for you. This is developed by Google itself. And basically this is an flexible framework for solving problems, and this include include processes like designing, prototyping, and testing ideas with users. So you can go to this website you can go through all the steps mentioned here, and after that you'll get a clear understanding about how to approach certain problem and how to find solution for that. Okay, I hope this is clear to you. Okay, so these were the top 10 finalists of 2021 Solution Challenge. You can see the teams were from Singapore, Canada, Turkey, Egypt. Basically, the teams were from all across the world. And you can find two teams from India, Eye of God, and second one is Swasti. Eye of God was an navigation system for visually impaired people, and Swasti was an app made to uplift users' health. So these two were the apps which were finalist in top 10, and Eye of God was in top 3 winners as well. So you can take inspiration from these videos. So these videos are from the demo day which I discussed earlier. On that demo day, participants discuss their solution with Googlers and experts live on YouTube, and the judge panels ask questions based on their solution, and they give suggestions on that. So you can always watch these videos to get inspiration, and we'll provide you with these videos too. Okay. So what participants said earlier who were part of Solution Challenge. So for Android, they said that developing an Android app from Android Studio is so easy and enjoyable. For Flutter, they said that Flutter helped us to become more productive. So if you see the details of these feedbacks, you get to know that many people were beginners in their development journey. They started their development journey with Solution Challenge, because Solution Challenge is for about 3 months, okay? And 3 months is a great time to learn something and build something. Does not matter whether you win the Solution Challenge or not. What matters is that experience, the experience you get while working with your teammates. Because while working with your teammates, you not only improve technically, but also your soft skills improve, your communication skills increases, your teamwork skills increases. So I strongly suggest you to please participate. Even if you don't know anything about development, please do participate. And if there are any problems regarding technically or non-technically, you can always reach out to GDSE core team leads. And also you can go and watch those resource videos as well, and you can see the reviews of TensorFlow, Firebase, and GCP as well. Okay, so this was the demo day of 2021 Solution Challenge, which I mentioned earlier too. So what demo day is, the top 10 finalists of the Solution Challenge discuss their solution with the Googlers and experts. And this is the link for that playlist of demo day of 2021. You can watch those demo days to get inspiration. Yes, so here comes the FAQs part. So many of you might be having questions regarding that, can my solution solve a problem outside of the scope of 17 sustainable developer goals? So as per the solution challenge guidelines, you need to target one or more of the 17 sustainable development goals. If you don't target any one of them at least, then you will be not be eligible to move forward. The next question, common question would be, can one student or team submit with multiple submissions if they have contributed to both projects? So for that, so the answer for this is no. According to the terms and conditions, there is only one entry per person. You can't submit multiple projects. And the next question would be, can I still participate in solution challenge if there is a no Google Developer Student Club at my university? So I covered this earlier. If there is no GDSC at your college, you what you can do is you can mention any GDSC which is near you, or any GDSC at your friend's college, and you can involve that friend in your team. So here it is mentioned that as student you can participate as long you team up with at least one student at an existing GDSC university. So here's an answer for you. So next question would be, given implications of the social distancing, our ability to test with users was impacted. Will the judges consider this? So for this, the judges will surely be mindful of the limitations that have been added to COVID-19. So don't worry on that part too. And if you have any more questions, you can reach out to me, or you can reach out to any of the team leads from the GDSC DYPCOE. Okay, so here comes the last part, and we can't wait to see what your our clubs, our GDSC DYPCOE club builds for this solution challenge, and we are really excited for this. And in any case, if you have any query, then as I said earlier too, you can always reach out to us on Discord or on our LinkedIn's or on our WhatsApp. Okay, so here we go. I thank you all of you for becoming and for being and such a great audience and hearing me patiently throughout the event. So if any one of you have any doubt, please unmute yourself and ask your doubt.
Hello, bhaiya.
Yes.
How to add a member in our group? If student is not from our university.
Like you are from DYPCOE, right?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. So if you want your friend to be your teammate, then not an issue. You can always include him in the team, and just you have to enter the name and name of him while submitting the solution.
Okay.
Yes, that is at very end of that event. You have to submit it by 31st of March.
Okay.
Yes, thank you.
If anyone didn't join the Google developer right now yet, so can they join now?
Yes, you can join anytime. And as I said earlier too, if you are a team of four members, okay, and three of them are from other college, then not an issue. There should be at least one student who is from GDSC DYPCOE. That's the eligibility. Others can be from any college. And if you are from DYPCOE and you have still not joined GDSC yet, then you can join by going to the community page, which goes by.
I searched in Instagram, so there are the link they given is not right now. There.
Sorry?
The link to join.
GDSC. So yes. The link is just a second now.
I searched in Instagram and also
you can go to link tree /DSC_DYPSHOE and you will find the link to join the club. Hello?
Can you please say it again?
Is my screen visible?
Yes, yes.
So I'm sharing my screen. Here you can see the URL, that is linktree/DSC_DYPSHO. You can screenshot this or we'll provide you with this link. Unfortunately, the chat box is not working.
Okay, I have the screenshot now. Thank you so much.
Okay. Yes. Yeah. If you go to this link, you'll find all the links of GDSC DYPSHO. You'll find the community page link, the Discord server link, LinkedIn, Twitter, Instagram, and all other social media handles. Okay.
Okay.
Hello, Bhaiya.
Yes.
If at the time of form filling, we have to add a member, right?
Yes.
Okay.
So you have to go to this website. I will provide you with this link. So you have to click this register now button. And while registering now, you have to enter your email name and which Google Developer Student Club are you part of? You have to enter DY Patil College of Engineering if you are from DYPCOE. And how are you associated with GDSE? You have to enter member, okay? Please don't enter lead or core team member. Make sure you are entering member. And then are you part of GDSE at your own university or are you joining nearest one? So if you are from DYPCOE and are member of GDSE DYPCOE, then enter yes or else enter no. Then what technologies are you interested to learn about or plan to utilize in your project? Then enter the technologies which you will be using. And if you are not sure, then enter other and specify that, okay? And or if you are still confused, you can tick all those. And the next question is, which United Nations Sustainable Development Goals are you interested in? So here you have to enter the goal which you will be targeting. And if you have not decided yet, then you can enter not sure yet. And how confident do you feel about participating in solution challenge? You have to enter this on the scale of 5. And you can also describe the reason for your answer above this one, about the how confident one. And just enter I agree here. And I would like to, you can do it yes or no on your personal choice. And you go next and submit the form. So this is a very simple process to register for the solution challenge. And everyone register for this, and there will be another form to submit the solution. You'll receive it at the end of March or during the start of March. Okay. So I hope your doubt is cleared, right? It was Omkar, right?
Yes, yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Hello, Bhaiya, please share the link of Google form in chat box. There is chat box now visible.
Yes, okay. So let me tell you one more thing. If you go to our community page, yes, this one. So this is the community page link, and I hope every one of you might be familiar with this community page. So just go to this event. Or any event, you'll find the featured presentation for that event. So right now we have not uploaded the presentation for the solution challenge one, but if you go to any another previous event, you will find the featured presentation for that specific event. So if you anytime want any link which was there in PPT and you are facing problems to get that link, then you can find that PPT in that specific event section. And just go to that slide and you can find that link here. Okay.
Okay.
And also you can find the event recording here itself on that event page only. So do anyone else have doubt?
Form filling is not started.
A form filling has started. okay, your registration for Solution Challenge has started. What I'm saying is, but the final submissions have not started yet. They'll start during March.
So link.
Hello.
But where to fill the form?
You have to fill the form on that Solution Challenge website only. We'll provide you with the link. Don't worry. We'll provide you on your WhatsApp groups and on Discord also. And also we'll post it on our Instagram handles as well. Don't worry on that.
Okay.
Yes.
Hello. We are still not able to join the Discord club.
Is the link working here? Did you try this one link? This link only, no?
Yes, a lot of time, but they said there is not permission and all.
Okay, so we'll update this link. I guess it has expired a few days back. Okay, we'll update this. Don't worry.
Okay.
Can I know from which branch and year you are from? So
I'm from first year instrumentation.
Okay, we'll provide the links.
I'm from all the mechanical.
Okay.
We'll sir, provide mechanical also.
Okay. We'll provide the links on your mechanical instrumentation and all other departments group. So don't worry. Okay. So is there any doubt?
Hello.
Yes.
I wanted to know if we have to register as a team or as an individual for the challenge.
Right now, register as an individual, okay, and the team part, the registration for the team will be at during the mid of March or starting of March. So right now, every one of you, please register as an individual only. So there is no other option to register as a team. Here's the form, and you can see that you just have to enter name, which GDSC you are from. Or your friend's GDSC, which means your teammate's GDSC chapter. Then you have to just specify your position at that club, your member or what else. Then that's it. This is a very simple form.
Okay.
Yes. So does anyone else have any doubt? Please feel free to unmute yourself.
Yeah, what would be easy, Flutter or Android Studio?
Okay, so what you're asking is very different things. So Flutter is a technology used to build an app, and Android Studio is an tool to build an app, okay? So your question should be what is easy, Flutter or Kotlin or Java? Okay, so it totally depends on what kind of solution you are making, and it depends on your personal choice also, to which technology you are familiar with. It depends on you. And if you still have any confusion, you can always reach out to our Android lead Adarsh Shete and ask him doubts regarding Android or Flutter.
Yeah, okay, thanks.
Thank you, Aryan.
Hello, Bhaiya, please share the link, share the PPT of this in our WhatsApp group.
Actually, it would be difficult to share the whole PPT. What we can do is we'll upload the PPT on this event page, and you can get the access of PPT on this event page only.
Okay.
I think the same lecture was uploaded on YouTube after some time.
Sorry.
Okay. The same lecture was uploaded on YouTube after some time.
Yes.
Because the Android Study Jam was also uploaded on the YouTube.
Yes. Every event's recording will be uploaded on YouTube, and you can access the recording on through our YouTube channel or through the event page on our community page.
Yes.
You can take screenshot of this URL and join this chapter also. I'm really sorry that your chat box is not working.
Hello.
Yes.
Actually, I had a question about Android Studio. How can I know if it can be run on my device?
Okay, so you can know that by going to Android Studio's website, and there you can search for the device requirements for the Android Studio.
Okay.
Yes, and if you face any problem, then reach out to us.
Okay, okay.
We'll be always happy to help you. Okay. So, any more questions?
Does Flutter also require Android Studio for its project or something?
Yes, it requires.
Okay.
You can build Flutter apps on VS Code, but Flutter needs the SDK, which is in Android Studio only. So you need to at least download Android Studio.
Okay.
All the technical questions you can ask to our Android lead anytime. So any more questions?
Will you please show the slide of 17 subject sustainable? One second.
Is it visible? Please take a screenshot. Or else you can find these goals on that form or on the Solution Challenge website. We'll provide you with the links, but still take a screenshot if you want to. Any more questions, or should we end the meeting? Please unmute and say no if you don't have any questions.
No, we don't have right now. Thank you.
Okay. Thanks. Okay, guys. I hope the guy took the screenshot. I'm stopping my screen sharing. Okay. Thank you, everyone, for joining.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Pratim.
Thank you. Thank you.
Welcome. You can leave the meeting now.
Okay.
Yes. And we'll be giving further updates on Discord or on your emails. Okay. So don't worry.
Thank you.